The Ghana Association, you know, the Ghana National Association of Private Schools, which has been abbreviated and is known as GACOPS, has called for unity, you know, with it, within its members in the association. Apparently, there have been some misunderstandings and some people are not cooperating very well. Now, the acting president, who is Mr. and Dr. Damasus Turusong. I'll pronounce it again. Dr. Damasus Turusong has encouraged teacher unions to remain united so they can fight for their rights and entitlement. Now, there have been some people who have disagreed with what is supposed to be given to them, you know, within the association and all these stuff. So, and other issues have risen up where and some people have had serious disagreements too. So, because of this, the president, the acting president, is calling for them to be united and to be with one cause. Now, the acting president stated that although, you know, most of the teacher unions who were looking to advance their membership with the association were doing the right thing and that they were on the necessary, you know, path, they were supposed to do it in a certain peaceful way so that they could avoid this type of internal, you know, wars and conflicts that normally you know portray them as a weak, you know, association. According to him, though people hold differences in opinions, there was the need for them to work together so they could achieve, you know, a similar goal and keep moving forward. Now, he said, and I quote, "In any case, we are all aiming for one thing, and that is the best interest of our members, and that should be our focus, instead of struggling for membership and leadership positions." So, apparently, some of these other issues are with concern to who should head which position and who should have what, you know, benefits come his way. Some of the view, they deserve certain, you know, remuneration compared to others. There are some who are also of the view that they deserve to, you know, be leading in a particular area. Because of this, you know, a little, you know, misunderstandings here and there. And the acting president is unhappy about it. Because you already know the old saying, united we stand, divided we fall. This is not only in the GACOPS, but in every group and association where people, you know, have come together for a common cause. As long as there's a difference in opinion, if it's not, you know, treated properly and division comes in, the group will not function as it is supposed to function anymore. Now, the guy whose name is, the man whose name is, you know, his name is very hard to pronounce, but I'll try my best again. Mr. Damasus Turusong. Yeah, I got it right. Yeah. So, he said this, you know, when he got his turn to address this participants, they held a 6th quadrennial, you know, regional delegates conference. This is actually the 53rd, you know, regional delegates conference, but this is the 6th quadrennial of them. It was of this program that he addressed this situation. He was also at the, you know, Ghana National Association of Teachers conference, which was at WA in the Upper West Region on Monday. According to him, these were the ways, you know, troubles were able to spark up in the association, and when not checked, it led to, you know, serious issues. Now, this program particularly was used to mark the 90th anniversary of the NAT Association, that's GNAT, NAT Association, and it was on the theme NAT at 90. A lot of Nana inside there, NAT at 90. Huh. almost a tank twister over there. So that was the theme for the event. And it had another phrase and sentence behind it, which said, surviving as a reliable and vibrant teacher union in the 21st century. Yeah. Now, they wanted to address the threats of national policies on the trade union and all these, you know, different laws that were enacted that could affect them. Now, Dr. Turusong, who is also the proprietor for the Tupaso School of Excellence in WA, you know, he indicated that, you know, there was the need for the NAT, which is the biggest and oldest teacher union, to, you know, find ways to introduce some policies that will put behind those associations that were struggling, you know, and to watch the ways there were some speeches inside the association that could prevent them from moving forward. So he asked them to be careful with how they spoke and how they, you know, went about some of this stuff. Now, when you look at some of the influences this has on the nation, you'd see he wanted to join in them in having a good way in debating to advance the nation and, you know, social interest of the association, instead of it always being an argument like issue. And he said, according to him, in order to do this the right way, they should be wary of also self-interest and also third parties who would want to, you know, pitch a union against the other. Sometimes that's what happens. People who are outside a group are those who come and spoil the whole thing up. So he wanted them to be wary of that too. Now, he also called on the Ghana National Association of Teachers, you know, to do their best to protect their independence by making sure that, you know, those who were seeking for election as leaders in the group were not being sponsored by some political, you know, activists. You get it. Sometimes that's what some of these people do, and they destroy all the hard work that has been put in the association. He also asked that the leaders, the members who wanted to be leaders, should be checked to make sure they don't have any political interests, you know, so interest that would, you know, be a problem to the association when when their parties, you know, gain power. You know, this could have the wrong person, you know, pushing the association in places they are not supposed to be pushed to. Yeah, before you know it, it'll be Biden, you know, for the paymasters, those who are actually in the political places, who are actually pulling the strings. So he wanted them to be very sure that there's no political affiliation with regards to the one who wanted to be the leader of this association. Now, he also included the fact that sometimes these political people, when they have an influence in such association, they will not only look at their interest, but at the end of the day, they will find a way to destroy the plans that most of them have worked hard for and spent time to, you know, build upon. Now, the regional president of the NAT, who's Mr. Yvonne Cooley, some say Ivan, but Mr. Yvonne Cooley, said that this association was making sure they advance the welfare of their members. He also asked them to be ready, because he wanted them to introduce programs and some ideas that were going to, you know, work on some cancer cases, you know, in and around them. And also, he wanted to get them ready for a certain in-service training, which will equip their staff with the necessary skills, language, and the way they'll go about things, you know, in the association. Now, they were able to quote some of their figures. In 2017, their membership was at a number of 8,049. You get it. In 2017, they had 8,049 members. Now, at the end of May 21, after calculating the number of members, they realized that there was a great increase. It moved from 8,049 to 9,177. So you get it, that's a 1,000 increase. That's 1,000 plus increase over there. So they chose that there's definitely some interest in new members now. There are people who are seeing the light of what they are doing, and people want to get in. So his aim is to make sure that these new people who are coming in are not coming in with any unwanted behavior and mannerism, you know, just to put or spoil all the hard work that they've put in. So he's hoping that they will do this in-service training in the same way you do an in-service training when you go to a certain company or you are offered a certain job, just to prepare you for the work ethics, the way you go about stuff, and you know, you relate well with the people in the organization. Now, he also added that sometimes these policies and arrangements were very, very critical to some of the ways things were, you know, moved forward in their association. According to him, when you look at the way these motives are spearheaded, you'll find that the welfare of teachers, you know, for example, the centralization of services of the Ghana Education Services at their headquarters, and even other things with relation to education will keep things moving forward. But if they don't put those things in effect, then they will to delay things like promotions and even upgrading of members, even as well as even the adjustment of salaries that some people have been complaining about. So the original president of the NAT said that even inadequate staff and the accommodation that some of the teachers were receiving, even the limited supply of teaching materials, you know, and the delay in the release of capitation grants and all these things we've been hearing, you know, from the government, were some of the challenges that needed urgent attention. Now, he also added that though there were these problems, there was a need for them to take a good look at the main goal before, you know, moving with their decisions, because it's good to seek the interests of the members, the teachers, and what have you, but they shouldn't forget that they are there for a cause. They are there to make sure that certain people are protected, certain students are not left out, certain teachers receive the right things that come their way. You know, there shouldn't be a help me alone situation. It should be help us. It should be what is moving the group, is what is going to make things different, how they are going to improve upon the things that are done in the classroom, in the schools, and even in the nation as a whole. So he added that they should be careful of those things. Now, Mr. Ivan is actually one who has been very serious about, you know, doing his best as a regional president of the NAT. We've had reports in the past of how he's been serious with these types of moves, and how he doesn't wait for the last moment before he acts when it comes to certain serious matters. And people have noted that about him. He has this make sure it is done before this time type of attitude, and that's the type of characters and attitudes and traits that leaders are supposed to have. So there are certain things that he would relax on, but there are other things that he will make sure he beats the time to it, just to keep the general good of all those who are a part of this association. So he had talks with, you know, the acting president of the GACOPS, and they together, you know, were happy that they were on the same board. When he spoke to Dr. Damasus Torosong, they both were glad that they had the same interest and actually some of the same things they were planning on happening in the individual, you know, associations where they were what came up in these meetings and the like. So we'll see how it goes. In the meantime, what do you think about education in Ghana? What do you think about even these associations for teachers, the private ones, the government ones, you know, all these ones? How well are they, you know, implementing their purposes, their aims, their messages? And should we continue to look up to them? You can let us know in the comment section below. Thank you very much for listening and have a nice day.